Knut Fischer has a mammoth task on his hands, running what will probably soon be the largest refugee center in Germany. The hangars of Berlin's historic Tempelhof Airport, closed in 2008, are now home to 2,700 refugees. And there are already problems: insufficient sanitary facilities and privacy. They'll worsen once plans to expand the center are realized. Will Knut Fischer manage to provide a humane home for the temporary residents?
Wasser, eine Stunde, Waschbecken, eine Stunde, yes? Okay.
Habla, habla.
Moment, hit also, Moment.
The water supply isn't working. A major problem for those living and working here.
I know, because they are dirty. They are really dirty.
Knut tells the refugees there will be working sinks in 1 or 2 hours' time.
No more than 2 hours, I hope, because otherwise things could get a bit agitated here.
He shows some of the men the new sinks.
No. It's no water inside. In an hour we get water, and you have to put your feet here and make this, and then the water is coming here.
Knut Fischer then takes a police team around while telling them of the everyday conflicts that arise.
The last time was last Friday. It was because of a cell phone charger. The time before that was over someone pushing in while waiting for food.
Although he has not seen the kind of sexual attack seen at New Year's Eve in Cologne, he has problems of a very different kind to deal with here.
Can I have a look? Only a look for him? Sorry. Thanks a lot. Only to know how you live here. Yes?
Family.
Okay.
Family.
One family.
One family. Two family.
Two family. Okay.
Elf.
11 people. Okay.
And the 12th person?
This Frei.
There is none. We have two families in here, and sometimes there's a bed vacant.
What effect does living together so closely have?
There are many tensions, of course, mainly between the people living here. They don't have any privacy. They can go outside. But you're not alone there either. So there's no area, no space that you can really have to yourself. That's just how it is.
The tents have no electricity supply, so the few power outlets in the facility are in big demand. These hangars are soon to become home to some 7,000 people. But the police doesn't expect a rise in criminal behavior.
Judging from the experience from the other refugee centers in Berlin and across the country, we can say that significant increases in offenses near refugee homes have been the absolute exception.
The former airport is currently both a refugee home and a building site. Facilities so far comprise chemical toilets outside the hangars, with no sinks or washing machines, just a few dozen showers.
The situation with the toilets and showers is totally unsatisfactory, so tempers can fray pretty quickly because of all that waiting, without even their basic needs being covered.
Oh,
there's my water. I'll open up and get things moving.
Moin. Sie bringen Wasser, hoffentlich.
As hoped, a tank of water has arrived. First, they have to connect it up to the water supply in the hangar.
Da ist ein Wasseranschluss drin gelegt worden.
Na ja,
irgendwo. Und sie sagt, da ist keiner. Das hat bald jetzt zu
tun. Na, wir gucken mal.
The internal water supply connectors, it turns out, are locked. Knut Fischer is a social worker, not a plumber, of course. The technician gets to work.
Naja, schade drum. Was man hat, das hat man eigentlich.
Not the greatest start, was it?
I agree, but now we'll slowly be getting there. I hope.
Genau.
And what do you say to the people living here when they ask?
Well, we have the water. It's only a question of time until we can make it available. In any case, the word here everyone is most used to hearing is tomorrow. When they go to the authorities for registration or what have you, the answer is always tomorrow. You have to wait until tomorrow. People are used to it. It's a bit of a shame.
He's then called to see a family afflicted by lice, who are refusing to change their infested clothes. But the search for water has taken up so much time that by the time Knut arrives, the problem has been resolved.
Ja, schon klar. Das ist richtig. Wer ist die Mama? Wer ist die Mama? Ja, also geht doch. Very good, very good. Thank you very much. Okay, it's yours. Okay.
Now wearing fresh clothing, the family are allowed to re-enter the hangar. Where they now finally have running water. In these sinks at least.
I never imagined it being ready. But I feel better. And now I can focus on the clothes store. That's what we're off to next.
Ist doch gut. Passt.
One problem solved. Only for the next one to rear its head. The toilets have stopped working. Dua Sabar from Syria used to be a respected interpreter. Here she doesn't even have access to running water.
This one is closed today. They closed it. So this is the new WC. It's awful there. I didn't went there at all. I'm holding myself until now. This.
Thanks a lot.
You are welcome.
Oh, hi.
Hello.
We pay a visit to Kateba Nafia, a doctor from Syria.
I'm fine, and you?
You are welcome. I'm fine, too.
Okay, okay.
When I go out from my home, I don't sure I will come back or not.
Yes.
No, it is big different. When you compare my house with this tent, it is big different.
Yes.
But in same time, when you compare safety, it is more important than house.
Yes, that's right. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
When I feel safe, everything else it's not important.
Yeah. Okay.
It is more strong than war. Peace more strong than war.
So the people improvise, as they have gotten used to doing, including when it comes to doing their laundry in the sinks.
No, not for clothes. No, this is for, no, this is for hands, this and this, yes, genau. No, no. Yes, you're right.
Say,
no.
Does he mind?
No, not really. I probably did the same thing. The problem that arises is that when 10 families are doing their laundry, it means there's no water for the other 500 people to brush their teeth. They'll have to make do for just one more week, and then things will get better.
It's late in the evening here in Hangar 1 of the former Tempelhof Airport.
One round, five games.
Yeah.
Yes? Oh, okay.
So, Mr. Fischer, what's your motivation?
I learn something new every day. Today, playing cards. It's uplifting to see people who've had such a bad ordeal still having fun moments. The people here are getting a new lease on life, despite the terrible circumstances they've been facing. They're still able to find something positive. And I enjoy seeing that.
Ja, das macht einfach Spaß.